But I think what's really amazing about him is his youthful enthusiasm. He's like a 20-year-old. He's got lots and lots of energy. He's sort of up for stuff. Oh, this is great. Let's do this. Oh, fantastic. And he has this kind of energy and drive about him, which is incredibly impressive and inspiring. And it's a kind of charisma that rubs off on the people around him. It was interesting with John there because he particularly took a closer interest in my work when he heard Shufei play the Albanian concerto, heard that recording. EMI wanted me to do some orchestral arrangements, basically of Albanian piano pieces for guitar and orchestra. And I said, well, what about this? What about the idea of an Albanian concerto? You know, we imagine Albanian as a guitar composer, although, as we all know, he never wrote a note for guitar. But he's known for his music through guitar versions of it. So wouldn't it be fun if there had been an Albanian concerto? And Shufei is amazing to work with because she, you know, she doesn't look at the notation and duplicate it as many other players do. She's able to see the music through the notation, instantly gets what's going on musically. With David Russell, it's really interesting because the way we work together, we've done it on the couple of pieces we've worked on, is that I'll send a first draft of something. He'll video it and record it and send me the video, and then a whole load of comments about what he thinks. The thing I think that's really beautiful about David's playing is just his phrasing and his ability to throw a phrase over a long period of time so that it feels like it's sung or played with a bow instrument or wind instrument. I'd worked with Milos in one of my guitar quartets a few years previously. So I did the guitar part for his arrangement of Libertango. I did an introduction which had a lot of campanella effects before going into the main part. But it was a lot of fun because, you know, with a lot of these more commercial recordings, the time spans are very short. And the stuff has to be learned very, very quickly. And, you know, Milos is an amazing person to work with. He's given an almost impossible schedule, almost impossible amount of work to do in a short amount of time, and he just gets his head down and does it. Well, I think the thing I'm most interested in is writing a piece which is entirely bespoke for them, for their playing. One of my biggest fears as a composer is to repeat myself. It's the big danger. As Auden once said, you know, artists spend the first half of their lives copying other people and the second half copying themselves. So in order to sort of get a difference between these pieces, the more tailor-made they are for a particular player, that kind of helps them separate out. So the kind of piece I'd write for David Russell would be very different from the kind of piece I'd write for a John Williams, or a Shufei Yang, or a Milos Karadagic. For me, my big 20th century heroes are Miles Davis, who just needed to change all the time. Stravinsky, Picasso, people who kind of reinvented the wheel every time they sat down to work. That's the model, that's very exciting.